Hello everyone, this is Dennis at Boulder Sounds. Welcome to the video demo of the Crystal Glasses version 3. My buddy Bo Clausen has made some really beautiful KSP scripting that really enhances this crystal set. Basically, you have a crystal synthesizer here residing within Kontakt now. So if you're new to this library, just give you a quick overview. We've used 6 sets of crystal glasses, and you can see the crystal hits right here, instrument, and I have the crystals labeled 1 through 6. However, for each glass, we had numerous glasses to choose from, up to as many as 10. So here's a little graphic from the manual, and there's a beautiful PDF manual written up for you on the Kontakt library. And this is one example of the number of glasses I used that represents just one of those crystals pictured on the front instrument of Kontakt. So each one of these crystals actually has a slightly different tonal quality, slightly different pitch, etc. So we tried to utilize that to our advantage for variety. Here we've got a nice clickable contents in the PDF. There's another shot of the 6 crystal glasses. 6 crystal glass types, I guess I should say. And here's a couple more photographs of their groupings. So just to give you an overview of what you get in the download package, here's the crystal glass folder. And we have a folder for documentation. We have the full manual, as well as a brief What's New manual. That's what's new in version 3. We have an instruments folder and a samples folder. You don't need to be concerned with the samples folder, but in the instruments folder, we have some subfolders: bowed crystals, crystal combinations, crystal hits, crystal morphs, granular crystals, and singing crystals. So for example, if I open the singing crystals folder, we have a main instrument called Singing Crystals version 3 NKI, and then another folder which has examples in it where we've created some example presets for you to get an idea what you can do with the programming. So that's a nice way to get you started. So I think what I'll do this time, which is a departure from what I've done on previous videos, I'll just load some patches and let you hear some sounds, explain to you briefly what's going on. And then later in the video, I'll get into more detailed parameters of the various instruments. So I'm going to open the crystal combinations. So these are combinations of hits, singing crystals, granular crystals, bowed crystals. So they're multi-instruments, NKMs, in the Kontakt world. Here's a multi-instrument from the Crystal Combos folder that I particularly like. I'll solo each instrument. Here's the singing crystals. And here's the crystal hits. And below that, we have bowed crystals with a long articulation. And that comes in a little bit later in the sound. And together, we get this. So you get that nice crystal hit. Shortly after that, you get the singing crystal, and then after that, the kind of grainy sound of the bowed crystal comes in. And just a brief thing here is the left-hand column shows you the crystal layers, and you can see the green key switches down to the bottom left. And I can just turn these layers on and off using the key switches and have different crystal combinations. So there, I've just turned on 2 more layers. So I'll get into explaining those more later. Here's another cool sounding multi from the crystal combinations. This uses granular crystals, which creates a little bit of a almost electric piano kind of sound. And this also combines it with the bowed crystals, long articulation. However, there's a heavy use of effects there, so when you combine those two together, see on the right hand side of Kontakt, it shows you what's being used. We have LFO being used, a filter, chorus, and delay. And down on the lower right hand column, you see the same thing for the Bode crystals. So we have very extensive effects featured here. And I'll get into that more later. Here's another multi using the singing crystals and long Bode crystals. This is a nice big fat pad sound. See in the layers column, we're using three layers from each instrument, and we're also using space IR convolution on both instruments as well. Here's a combination from the Crystal Hits examples. This is a multi with three different crystal players. And by the way, the thunking sound you're hearing of the keyboard is my controller keyboard coming through my lapel mic. It's not actually in the samples. And then again, I can add more key switch layers like this. Here's some of the Bode crystals with a short articulation. So you get that nice bowed release. Here's a granular morph example, and you can see we're using granular layers 1 and 7 on both instruments. If I move my mod wheel, you'll hear the morph. Number 4. And so if I want to, you know, morph into a layer that's not on the next instrument, for example, on the second instrument, I'll turn on granular layer 2. And 3 and 6. So we're going from 1, 4, 7, we'll morph into 2, 3, and 6. So you can create some otherworldly sounds pretty easily there. Here's another example of singing crystals being morphed. You can see in the top instrument, we have crystals 4 and 5 are turned on. On the bottom instrument, crystals 1 and 2. Here's the morph. Back to 1 and 2. So 1 and 2 is nice and a little darker, warmer, excuse me, 4 and 5 are darker and warmer, and 1 and 2 are quite a bit brighter. Mm-hmm. Okay, so now I've loaded one of the crystal hit instruments. We'll look at this in more detail. We're on the instrument tab, and on the bottom right hand corner of the interface you'll see a drop down menu with various parameters that are accessible from the instrument tab. And then if I go to the effects tab, we have the same thing, and the settings tab. So you want to look at that drop-down menu when you go to the different tabs, or you'll be missing a lot of information. So on the left column here, we have the crystals that are used. These are crystal layers, and this particular instrument uses crystals 3, 4, 5, and 6. And in the column next to it, we have volume for each crystal layer, and we also have the tuning parameters for each crystal layer. And also notice up above it says hide crystals. You click on this button and you have access to the amplitude envelope parameters as well as pedal mode. And we always have this effects column here available to you from the front panel for quickly turning on and off effects, just kind of to quickly audition what they sound like. When you want to get into more in-depth detail of them, what you'll do is go to the effects tab, and then you can click on one of them and it'll take you directly to its corresponding page. So I will go back and turn off the EQ for now, back to the main instrument tab. Also at the bottom of these two columns, we have something, a button that says reset volume and reset tuning. So if you start tweaking the tuning or the volume settings, and you just want to go back to a reset value of 0, you just click on that button, and you're back to starting from scratch again. Also, show pan slash spread. We click on this button, and now it shows you panning controls for each layer, as well as the spread control. The spread control will give you a very wide stereo image, or a very tight image where you go down to a summed mono image. And a very important button is right here, save preset. So what we have is we have 6 preset slots. You can create your own presets and save them into each slot. And then you can also save that as a bank and load the bank later. Or you can save a specific bank as a default bank to load when you load up that particular instrument. Another nice feature is all 6 of these preset slots are filled with presets that we've created to get you going. So for example, if I click on preset number 3, you'll notice I've turned on crystal 3, 4, 5, and 6. And crystal 4 is panned minus 100. 6 is panned plus 100. And this is what this sounds like. A nice clanging kind of quality. If I go to my volume and tune control here, you can see the volume's been set differently on some of the layers. The tuning of crystal number 3 has been dropped down an octave. Here we've gone up 5.1 semitones, and crystal 6, 6.92 semitones. So that's what kind of gives us that kind of clashing frequency sound, but it's very nice. So you can just go through these various presets. That'll give you some ideas of some different combinations you can set up on your own. So now with the same hits instrument, I'll hide the crystals. I'll click on hide crystals button, and we have access to the amplitude envelope parameters. And what we have is the attack speed, the attack curve, convex or concave shaping, release, and also a nice feature here, sample start. So that will start at the first sample or gradually into the sample as you increase this value. So you'll get a slightly, typically on the hits, you'll get a darker tone as opposed to the initial transient attack sample. And of course, you know, if you change this and you want to set it back to its default value, you just do command click. on the Mac, and it's back to its setting. So what I'll do is I'll assign a slider to the attack here. So I right click on it, learn CC automation, and then I just move my slider that I want to control that. And so here's zero attack. So if you want a slightly softer edge, maybe just take a little bit off, a couple milliseconds, or something more drastic. And then the curve, I'll assign that to a different slider. So you can see it really changes the sweep of the attack sound. And the release, of course, is going to shorten or lengthen the release. Okay, so I'll set those back to their default values. And the sample start. So you see at 13 milliseconds, it's a bit different sound quality versus the default zero. Quite a bit brighter on the attack. Here we have a button called Sustain On, and when we turn that off, you see above it, it changes to damping. The knob will control a certain amount of damping, so we'll get this sound now. So the sustain pedal is not really doing anything. If we want to lengthen that, that's what this knob is for. So still short, but a little more sustain to it, or I can shorten that. And I still have these controls that I can play with, for example, my attack control. And sample start and attack curve and so on. In this column we have something called pedal mode. If I change this button from pedal sustain mode to pedal damper mode, what I can do is play a series of notes, they'll ring, and then I'll hold down my sustain pedal and it'll trigger the dampered setting over here. So you have two articulations against each other. That sounds like this. And if I want to change the settings of the damper to shorter or longer, I would do that with this knob. Here I have a volume control button. Right now, volume is being controlled by velocity. I could change that to a continuous controller number of my choice. And the right-hand column, we see effects, and these are simply just to turn the effects on and off from the front panel very quickly to audition something. When you want to get in more detail to editing the effects, you go to their respective page. But if I just want to quickly turn on the chorus here, just to get an idea of what it might sound like, there's some delay, space IR convolution. We'll get into those in more detail in just a moment. Now I'm going to move from the main page to the performance page to just give you a brief explanation of this. Stereo field controls. You can control the width of the stereo image from mono, which is summing the left and right side stereo samples, to a very wide exaggerated spread of 100. This would be mono. Panning controls, panning the instrument more to the left or to the right. Ping pong. So when this is all the way counterclockwise, that's off. This distributes each note alternating the left and right channel. And depending on how extreme you want it, this would be this setting. So here's an extreme setting. I'll just play two notes back and forth. just a more subtle setting. Global volume just controls the volume of the instrument. Humanize, this is a very nice feature to have. So this will randomize your timing of your notes played if you don't want it to sound quite so perfect. Same thing with the tuning. And you have randomization of the velocity. So we can just move this clockwise all the way up to 100, down to 0, just turns those controls off. And from the drop-down menu on all the tabs, we have the About page. If you just click on that, it's a built-in manual written right into the interface of Kontakt. If you don't want to refer to the PDF and you just need a quick reference, the PDF is a little bit more detailed with graphics and clickable links and things like that. So now I've just loaded up one of the singing crystal instruments. You can see the front interface is very similar to the hits. We have the layers, your volume control, tuning control, etc., effects. But what I'd like to do now is go to the LFO page. So what we can do from the main page is just drop down here and choose the LFO page, or if you wish to, you can just click on the LFO button on or off. That'll automatically turn it on. And here we have access to LFO parameters. On the LFO page, we have something called LFO control. It's a drop-down menu. It defaults to no control. If you click on main LFO, what will happen is your settings here on the settings page, right here it says select continuous controllers. You can assign your continuous controller to affect the LFO there. And we can also do the same thing with volume. Have a continuous controller for that. For right now, I'll just turn that off. Main LFO. Okay, so here we have sync on or off that will synchronize to your DAW. And down here where it says frequency, you have all these different timing options, which are divisions of your clock on your DAW. But for now, I'll turn the sync off. And on the main LFO, we have a drop-down menu with our waveforms to choose from. We can turn the phase on or off. This is my frequency control, so I'll assign that to a slider on my keyboard. Put it around 3 hertz or so. And on the right side, it shows what the LFO will be modulating. So for example, if I want to modulate volume, I'll set this to about 44%. Look, we should get a nice pulsating tick sound. So I'm just changing the frequency of the LFO there. So if I set the volume back to 0, let's take a look at the filter. So if I want to modulate the filter, I change the percentage of modulation here, but nothing will happen because I don't have the filter turned on. So I need to turn on the filter and go to the filter page. Right now it's set to a 2-pole low pass. Let's go to a 6-pole low pass. And let's see what happens. Here's my cutoff control. I'll assign that to another slider. Change the resonance. That'll emphasize the frequencies at the cutoff point. Tracking will basically react to where I'm playing on the keyboard. Bring it up to 11. Let's change the filter to a high pass. To the LFO page, increase my speed, get so extreme. And of course, all this is real-time controllable. So what about the sub-LFO? That's down here. You just click on this button. We have sub-LFO settings. We have the same choice of waveforms. And it's telling me on the right what it's modulating. Right now it's modulating the main LFO. So if I just want to hear what this sounds like, I do need to increase the frequency percentage that it's going to modulate the main LFO. So let's just crank that up pretty high to 79%. This is a sine wave set at 1 hertz in frequency. Let me increase that. And of course, I can assign a slider to that frequency. If I change this to a square wave, you'll see I have a pulse control now, how wide the pulse of the square will be. So what if I don't want to modulate just the main LFO? I can use the drop-down menu and just have it modulate the volume and the pan. And notice that disappears from up here, and it's now assigned to the sub-LFO. So I can choose the amount of modulation I want for each control. So here's volume, and the square wave is now going to be modulating the volume. One more pulse. Modulate the pitch. Change the frequency. Change the waveform to triangle. So you can hear the speed of the pitch modulation was very slow here and exaggerated. And it's so fast here, you really don't hear it. It's just kind of a weird granular effect. All coming from crystal glasses. And just a little bit about the filter page. You do not necessarily have to use this in conjunction with the LFO. That's just an option. You can just have basic filters to set up and to choose from and set your frequency. For example, here's a low pass 4-pole filter. Can increase the resonance and something I've yet to talk about, which I should have earlier, is the presets. We have all these filled up with different filter settings for you to play with. And notice we have an advanced filter envelope control as well. So if you want to control the way in which the filter reacts to an envelope, you can do that here. And we can just turn this advanced envelope on and off. Here we just have attack and decay and the amount. Here, if you want to get a little more tweaky, You can have the attack curve, sustain, and release on the filter envelope as well. But here's just a few presets of the filters. This one's using a 6-pole low pass. So if you want to study the way filters react, this is a great way to get started. You can just choose a preset and just have a look and see how it's set up. That's a very nice one. You can tell how the tracking is affecting the filter. It's oscillating itself. When I go back to 1K, it's perfectly in tune. And I'd like to give you a quick tour of the effects available. So if we go to the Effects tab, we have a drop-down menu with your different effects. Here we have Space IR Convolution. You can switch to standard contact reverb if you want something that's less CPU intensive. Also, we have a high pass and low pass filter setting on the IR Convolution. That's something new in this version. And we also have a bunch of presets. So if you just want to run through these presets just to see what's out there. And notice that none of that worked because I don't have space turned on. And I can increase the space size or the amount. So you have all these spaces to choose from, and they sound great. So that's one very important principle, is make sure the button is turned on in white before you start tweaking. Here on the EQ, we have just a simplified EQ, bass, mid, and treble. If you want to get more an advanced EQ with bandwidth control, etc., you can click on that button, and again, we have presets for you to choose from. Chorus page. This is actually part of the modulation page. On the drop-down menu, we don't have only chorus. We have a lot. We have flanger. We have phaser. And a rotary speaker as well. And so lots of control over the effects. So now I've loaded up the default granular crystals instrument, just to have a little different sound to demonstrate. We have 7 granular layers, and you can just turn them on and off. These are nice evolving textures, pad-type sounds. All made with crystal glasses, and we can just turn our layers on using the key switches down here, or I can use my mouse. Also, don't forget the presets. We have these presets filled up with different combinations for you just to try out. Now I'll show you a little bit of the settings tab. On this tab, we have key switches, which we can reassign. So for example, if I don't want my green key switches down here that turns the layers on and off, I could just click on granular layer number one and relearn that, and I'm going to move it from this low C up to this higher range. And I just press the key that I want, and there it is. If I want to switch it back to where it was before, I just do the same process in reverse, and there it is. So you can make your own key switch assignments. It has to be outside of the blue range, though, because those are where the samples are mapped. Keyboard. This is an imaging control, so this just gives you the sense that you're the player sitting on the stage playing versus sitting out in the audience. This is called public perspective, and you have control over that. Spread will just give you a more exaggerated panning effect on the keyboard, how wide the sounds are panned from low end to high end. Velocity control is set at 75% right now. You can change that if you wish. This pitch bend column is kind of cool. So we have bipolar pitch bend settings. You can just set these independently if you want. But right now you see my button is link is turned on. So if I turn that off, I can set them independently. So 4 half steps up, 6 half steps down. If I turn the link on and I move one of these, they move in tandem. They act as one knob. So there's 5 half steps both up and down. If I turn on the only last note off button, only last note on, what will happen is I might play a, say, a drone note or a chord, and then I play another note and use the pitch bend. It will only affect just that last note played. And one thing I'd like to clarify here is when you look at the folder structure of the crystals, for example, if I open the crystal morphs folder, we have these setups for crystal morphs, and these are just default setups. They don't have any particularly special programming contained within them. If you want to see some of the, or load some of the examples here, that has all the kind of juicy programming. But if I load one of these, let me just show you what we'll get as a result. So I'm going to load a granular crystal morph times 3. And what that means is we have 3 granular instruments to morph between. And you can see the first instrument is set on granular 1. The second one is also granular 1. And the third one is granular 1. So nothing special there at all. So if I move my mod wheel, it's really not doing anything. But the idea here is that now you can create your own setups from these. So as an example, let's just change the second granular instrument to granular number 3, turn off number 1, and we'll put on number 6 on the third granular instrument. So we should get a morph from 1 to 3 to 6 as I move the mod wheel. Okay, very simple idea. So what we'll do now is take it just one step further. So in the middle instrument, you'll notice it's a lower sound. That sound. So I'll bring the tuning up here in the tuning column. Just type in plus 12. So now it'll be up an octave. Okay, and in the third morphing instrument, I will bring this one down an octave. So I'll type in minus 12. So then as a next step, I might solo instrument number two, morph number two, and I need to move my mod wheel to the center so I can hear this. And we might go turn on the EQ, go to the effects page, and just very quickly, I'll scoop out the mid-range. Bring the treble up a bit. See what that sounds like in context. Kind of interesting. Let's do some flanging. So go to the chorus page, turn it on, go to the drop-down menu, choose the flanger, and I can control this, and I'll solo this by the amount. Bring the volume down just a bit. Here it is in context. Maybe on that same instrument, I'll turn on the space IR convolution, and we'll use a church setting, and this is my amount control here. And again, I have to move my mod wheel to the correct place to hear it. Add the amount. So that's really soaked. Okay, now I'll try to move one step further. I'm most likely going to ruin the sound, but that's my style. Let's go to the first instrument. And let's turn the LFO on. And let's use just the main LFO, triangle, and we will modulate the filter. So I need to turn the filter on. Change the cutoff. Increase the frequency a bit. Maybe I'll assign that to a controller. Thank you. back to the filter page. I can turn it on and off to get there quickly if I want. Increase resonance. So it's emphasizing that cutoff point. Listen to it in context with the whole multi. So those abrupt changes were just moving the mod wheel to its extreme settings, back and forth. Okay, so I haven't totally ruined the sound yet, but I'm sure I will eventually. So let's go down here to instrument number 3, I'll solo that, move the mod wheel all the way forward. And what shall I do to this? Let's go to the LFO page. And I'll assign this frequency to another slider. And we'll have this modulate the filter also. And so I need to turn the filter on that page. Let's go to a high pass. Bring up the resonance. Go back to the LFO page. See what we get on this instrument. Okay, so my filter setting could be improved, the frequency. Change it to a band pass. And I can go right back to the LFO page by clicking that on and off. Let's use the sub LFO. We'll use a sawtooth. We'll have it modulate the main LFO. Let's assign this to another slider. Kind of a quirky sound. Let's go to the EQ page. Oops, sorry. Let's use the preset. Strange. Here's it in context. Should turn down that second one. So that's fun noise making, I suppose. Anyway, thanks for watching the video. I've only scraped the surface of all the stuff in this volume. You could spend days working with it, creating interesting sounds. So I hope you enjoy it, and best wishes to you from Boulder.